Hello guys, welcome to our YouTube channel AI Trends. In our channel, latest updates for the AI artificial intelligence relevant domain will post on our videos, and then the famous topics in our AI will make it as a tutorial, like Flask. Now we are discussing for Flask tutorial now, like that we'll make it as tutorials and then we'll post it in our YouTube channel. Please keep subscribe and support our channel AI Trends. Today we'll discuss Flask tutorial. In Flask tutorial, Flask is a Python web framework. If whatever machine learning, artificial intelligence, data science, we are using Python. Okay, if we build on a machine learning algorithm and build a model, how we can serve as an API to clients, or how we can show the demo to your client or your higher authority, means you need to make it as an API request. Okay, so now we'll discuss for how to make an API request for our application, like a machine learning model or any small addition multiplication. First, today we'll separate it into real time and sample example. Okay, sample example, simply addition multiplication value if we given means it will add and multiply that value sent to the client side. Okay, that is a simple example. Another one example, dog cat classifier. If we are uploading any images, it will predict that is cat or dog, and it will send the response to client. Okay, we'll discuss on this two. First, we'll cover the introduction part. Okay, here major four parts will be there. One is we need to import Flask packages mandatory. Okay, after that we need to call the constructor module in our Flask Python file. Okay, after that root option, root decoder, we need to import. With this root decoder, two operations will be there, two parameters will be there. One is rule, another one is options. Rule operation, what it will do means what are the URL you are giving, it will bind in a browser what are the URL you are giving, that URL will bind with the corresponding function in your Flask Python file, and then it will send the response to the client. For the particular module, it will send the response to the client. Okay, and then option will be the important part. The options will added for data retrieval protocol functions, like HTTP methods will be there, get, post, put, delete methods. We'll discuss on next that one only. First of all, why we are using HTTP protocol? It is a data retrieval protocol. We can send the objects, audio, text, image, anything, we'll send to server side and then get back into response to client side. With the communication medium, we'll use HTTP protocol. Okay, the five major methods will be there: get, head, post, put, delete. Okay, post method is, we'll use post method, it is enough for client and server both. Okay, after that, the objects we are sending for client to server, that will be five categories will be there. One is form data, will send it in a HTML file, will given a name, subject, like that if we given means it will be take it as a corresponding key value pair, name this value and then subject this value, like that it will take. And then that key value pair will be in a form data, it will send to the server side, will handle in form object. Another one is args. Args, via we can take it as value, and then we can process it. Cookies, files. Files will be image file, video file, audio file. If you are uploading, means it will directly take it as a file object. It will send to server, and then we can take. Okay. After that, URL for and redirect. Why we are using is, what are the function we are, what are the URLs we are giving in a browser, it will redirect and it will run the root decoder. Okay, with the root decoder will dynamically binding another URL, and then it will get back to that URL. Means we'll use URL for. I will show you the demo for the next practical session. And redirect, it will redirect to the corresponding URL, specific URL. What are the URL you are mentioning in URL for, it will redirect into the particular URL. Okay, come, we'll go for the practical session. Here, this is our GitHub repo. I already cloned the GitHub repo. Here the GitHub repo, and then I already created virtual environment. I already installed everything. Just see in the requirement.txt what will be there. Just we'll see. I already installed the packages. These are the files. Pip install flask is enough. If you want to install the requirement.txt, pip install requirement.txt. I already installed the every packages, so it is showing requirements already satisfied. Okay guys, then now we'll go for practical demo. See, first of all, we need to import the Flask module, and then these are the functions also we are using: redirect module, URL for module, and then request is very important, because in client side, what are the data you are sending in a post method are we are taken here with the corresponding method operation, and then the hold on the data we can get now by using request, we can get the data. Okay, via form or args or files format. Okay, here this is an important part. We need to call the constructor module. It will hold on the corresponding Python file name. Okay, just here why we are giving render template, means we didn't discuss previously, now we'll discuss on what it will do. Means render template, if you are now we are giving corresponding IP address with the port number, it will be in a this URL. Okay, normally it will load. If it is with nothing you are giving, means it will be showing for error. Okay, so that time you need to given a HTML file, it will load the HTML file. Defaultly it will load the HTML file. After that HTML file, what are the values you are hitting, it will redirect, it will comes here, and then we'll send it into response to client. Wait, without this we will run. Simply you'll see what we are doing here is simply with the corresponding IP port number. Okay, we can give it to here our customized IP and then port number also. Here I am setting as 5001, default port number is 5000. Okay, see, now I changed into Flask server. I changed as a Flask API server. This is enough for us. Okay guys, what I did here is, if corresponding IP with port number slash operation if we do in this, we'll send it to a value b value here. With the a value b value, what it will do means, I will explain you this part after that, then you will understand very clearly. With the a and b value, we can add and multiply it, that value we can send. Okay, now we will see without browser how we can check it as our server, it is working fine or not, it is giving corresponding request to response or not, we will check. Okay, what we need to do means, we have a REST API, advanced REST API client. With that we will test it as our Flask server code. Okay, now I will run this file. Here now we have this URL. If you given this URL means, in browser it won't work because it not defaultly render any, okay, not loading any web pages. That's why what we need to do means, here if you are giving defaultly rendering into admal html file, it will load that file. Okay, now if you go means, it will load that html file. HTML file, this is for a Jinja template. Okay, what are the format in Jinja template means, in a templates folder you need to add that HTML file, you need to give render template that HTML file name, it will directly go to templates folder and take it as admal HTML file. Okay, once check it, this is for the simply two text boxes and then on submit. In the submit, name A, name B. If you are giving submit means, that will hit on this URL. This URL is nothing but this decorator root function only. After that, it will send the response to that client. Okay, just now we will check it in REST API. Simply if you go means, add to Chrome, it will add, after that it will open. It is open. Without browser, we don't know much about UI means, we'll simply give the request to here. This URL we need to check it is working fine or not. Okay, here I already given the brief explanation for how to use REST API client. First go to Chrome browser, add your REST API extension, after that open the extension using post method with the URL, and then you need to add a and b value as a form data, and then you can hit on the request, it will send the response, server will send the response to client. Okay, see, I added, after that go to body. Here you add form data, our son is form data. With the form data, parameter will be a, once again, sorry. Okay, actually we need a text part. Okay, a value will be 10 and then b value will be 20. Okay, after that we'll hit on the request, we'll see what the problem here. Here we have a 5001 port. Here, see guys, the result is coming here. Addition is 30, multiplication is 200. Here the request is processed. See, addition is 30, request. Another one request if we send means, we'll change the value 1, 2. Now hit the request, it's send. Addition is 3, multiplication is 2. Okay, now our server is working fine for the request and response. Okay, so what we need to do now, we can go for browser. With the browser we have a UI, we created a simple UI. Here we'll give 35 2. Here we are giving a wrong port number, that's why it's throwing the error. You need to give the correct one. Here we didn't check yet. Okay, what we did here is, with our this one we given a wrong URL, everything we need to check. Okay, now once again we'll run the server. Now we'll go the browser, load that URL. Give 1 12 1. It is send the response to client side. In browser we are seeing the results. Once again, see this. Okay, 1 2 1 3. Request is processed and responses came here. That's it. Like this only we need to test the our server, it is working fine or not. So with the simple UI, let's see in real time for how we can publish this URL, this application, this client side application in a public. Okay, simple thing only what we need to do is, here I discussed, after that hosting the web application in global domain. Okay, with the ngrox we'll do that. Okay, we download the ngrox. Okay, I have already ngrox, so I will directly go there. Okay, copy, I'll paste it here. With the ngrox I will run, two parameters will be there. With the ngrox our HTTP port is 5001. If we run this one means, it will give on URL. With the public URL it will be valid for only 8 hours only, after that it will expire. So let's see with this URL what you need to do means, here our client, our web application will be there now. Here you need to replace and then save it. After that, again restart the server. Again restart the server. Now this URL and both this URL also will work. See, in this URL will be using mobile, you can use this, it will open this page. After then you can check it also, because if you make it as a machine learning model or something in Python, you need to show it in your client or your higher authority in another place. You need to show it as a demo with the temporarily, means you can use it ngrox to create a temporary public domain URL, and then you can make it as your application in a global. Okay, now I hit on, it will send the response to me, it responds to the client, and we are showing here. Okay, then now next we'll go for a practical machine learning model will be there with the model, how we can serve as a API request. Okay, how we can test in REST API, how we can change it as a public domain as application. Okay, first of all, I would like to thanks for this one, because I cloned the GitHub repo for a dog cat classifier real time application for here. The model they released, with the model I took the model and then I make it as a API. Okay, come here, we'll clone it. Here I already mentioned the step-by-step procedure. Just go through, clone it in my GitHub repo and then practice it. Here I already make it as a API, Flask API Python file. I will show it to you. This is only ours. Just I cloned and I will show you how to do that. Okay, simply the dog cat classifier get data set will be, model will load, Keras model will load. So we imported Keras module. After that the dog cat classifier, here dog cat classifier in get data set get image file will be the preprocess file. With the preprocess file, we need to preprocess the uploaded image, dog image or cat image. We preprocess and then we show it into converted into NumPy array, and then we passed into model. Okay, simply what we did here is the predict.py, what they did, we are did in a class, we initialize in a model, we are loading and initializing here in a constructor. Whenever we are creating an object, the model will load. With that object, we call it is predict result function, and then we'll send it into image and we predict the result. Okay guys, so now I will run the file. With this file will be 5000 port, that is in 5001 port. Now come, just I will activate the environment. I already created the environment. So I activated the environment. After that, I'll run the server, dogcat classifier server. Before, we need to check everything will be correct or not. We need to check, okay. What will happen here is it will defaultly load the dogcat classifier HTML file. Dogcat cat HTML file is nothing but this is for in temp here. Simply that is also on form data. With the form we are uploading for name for this key file key. We upload the image, it will take it and it will send it to here. We need to change this URL. We didn't okay guys, come, let's see. Now we are running the file. Because the model will be the Keras model, it will load TensorFlow as a backend. After that we'll see it. First of all, we will check it in a REST API. After that we'll go for browser. Okay guys, and see in this port number our function will be predict dog. Okay, predict dot function. With the predict dot function, our son is now will be file part. Okay, so add file part. Our name is file, okay. Key will be file. So what we need to give? We need to give file as a name, and then we'll go and we'll choose it into dog or cat image. I have already dog and cat images. We'll test it that one. Here we have cat image. With the cat image, we uploaded here. Now we send the response to the server. We'll see. It is sending the response to me. Image predicted as cat. Okay. Another use case we'll test is this is dog. Now we send the request to server. It is predicted as dog. Okay. Now we'll go for browser. In browser, 50. It will defaultly render for dog cat HTML file. Okay, this is an UI. Here I upload cat image and I hit on submit. Here small problem will be there. Wait, actually we didn't change the URL. I think so. So here we'll go. The HTML file will be we given a submit. It's not redirecting. We did small mistakes here. We changed the URL and we'll check it. Yeah, we did small mistake. No problem. Now we'll again run it our server. This is previous one, so leave it this one. Now we'll go there. Now the browser, now we'll take cat and then hit on submit. We did small mistakes. URL is a problem here. Actually, here it on yeah, it's working fine. Small, the actually we didn't load at the browser, that's why the UI didn't change yet. So now not a problem. Here, see the next thing, cat will predict dog, now we'll predict, it's predicted as dog. Okay, now we'll change it as a public UA. Okay, now this our zone is for 5000 port, go there with the ngrox. HTTP, now 5000 port in this URL, we'll take this URL and paste it into your HTML page for whenever submit the URL, it will here we'll paste in this URL. Now it is also for hosted in a public domain. Now we'll go there in browser, we'll open this, it will open the application. Now wherever you upload the file, the server will get the request and then it will send the response to the client side. Now we'll see. Yeah, it's working fine. Please subscribe our YouTube channel and we'll get the more good content. Please thank you for watching. Please share this video to your friends and colleagues and like. Thank you so much.